Good morning, dear children. How are you all? Excellent? Yes. Here, we will start new lesson that is from grammar and that is lesson number 4, kinds of nouns. Very easy lesson that nouns you have learned in your previous classes also. So this year also we have the new little bit extra steps that is in this lesson, that is noun. So what is noun? What is noun, dear children? Yes, you are correct. Naming words, any name, naming words are called noun. What is here? What is the definition of noun? Noun, a noun is a word which names a person, place, thing, animal, or even an idea. That is called noun. In short, naming words are called any name. Any name of animal, person, place, thing is called a noun. So, what is okay? As I said that the naming words of a place, people, idea, quality, or things. So what is people? People, maybe Mona, Sarah, Alex, Gaurav, any name. You know, that is people's name. Place name, the place. That place, maybe there would be Delhi, Ratnagiri, you know, our place here, Khed, you can say Chennai, Mumbai, any, that is a place. So that we can say the place. Idea, what type of idea or quality? You know, these two, can you see? See, 1, 2, 3, that is people, place, things, that is, you know, physical is there. Physical appearance is there in the nouns, in this noun. But in ideas and quality, there is no physical existence. There is no physical existence. Suppose if I am saying Mona, Mona is there. If I am saying Shamal, Shamal is there. Existence uska hai, it is there. You know, see the same way the idea, love, happiness. There is no physical existence, love. Happiness, you know, which quality? Now she is very happy today. So which quality? That happiness quality is there. That's the idea. Honesty. Honesty, you know, one proverb is there. Honesty is the best policy. So this is idea. This is an idea that we are going to be seeing. And the things, any things. Pen, my watch, my bangle, you know, TV, table, benches, all, clock. These are the things. So this is all the word which names a person, animal, thing, it's called a noun. And there are, how many types of nouns are there? Nouns, we have the kinds of noun, we have the types, we can say the types also, we can say nouns also. So first is proper noun, common noun, collective noun, material noun and abstract noun. In this, in your class, there are 4, you know, and 2 more, that is a countable and uncountable, that also we are going to be seeing in this lesson. So we'll see this first 5. What is that, a proper noun? Proper noun always starts with capital letter. Proper noun always starts with, keep in mind, proper, particular. Proper in sense, if I am saying that, now I will show you, that is a particular name. So any name of this people, place and the things, right? So that is always, it is very easy clue that whenever that noun starts with the capital letter, that we say that is a proper noun. Proper noun, India, Rohit, Khetan, see. Here it is a fan, but I am talking about Khetan fan. You know, the different companies are there. Where is Khetan? So it's a capital. See here, January. See, it would be month of month. It could be the days of the week, it any name. I'm saying now it could be the mall's name, it would be, you know, nowadays D-Mart is there. So that is, if I'm saying that I'm going to Prozon Mall, P. When we are right, any type of name, if I am telling you that the hospital, the big hospital, suppose we are saying the Bombay Hospital, if you are saying the Jahangir Hospital, hospital, that is different. But if I am saying that, but okay, school, any schools are there. But if I am talking about a Rotary English Medium School, Rotary, that R, so that's the capital. So the proper noun always begins or start with capital letter. So for example, India, Rohit, Ketan, January, month of month, you know, Monday, day of weekly days, that is a Monday. That is called a proper noun. See here, dear children, now let me see the common noun. Common noun, noun. It's very common. Now, as I said, teacher, teacher, principal, principal. Suppose I'm saying boy, girl, market, zoo, I'm saying hospital, tailor, nurse. If I'm talking teacher, okay, you go and give that teacher. Teacher, common noun. Tailor, common noun. When we are adding the name with that, that is called a proper noun. That I will say. See now here, country. Common noun, country. But country, maybe India, maybe Australia, maybe USA, maybe UK. So that is only country. So this is a small letter. Are you getting? This is a proper noun, always starts with capital letter. But the common noun, no particular country. We don't know which country, that is a common. So country, see, India is a country, but here the common country, don't know which country. Now boy, boy, which boy? Don't know, there is no particular boy. So see here, Rohit, see the difference, can you must understand that. It's very easy to understand the difference. Now I said that boy over. Boy is not a particular boy, so I have written only boy. Here, fan, any fan. It is not a particular fan. So, see here I have written the Ketan, the particular. So, the capital. Now here, month. Any month, maybe any month, would be any month. So, here, month, day, any day. So, this is the difference, you know, little bit different in your proper noun and common noun. Common noun is a general. We are talking general about, now see here one example I have written here downside. What is that? Mohit likes to go to the zoo and see the animals. See the animals. What is the naming words? Which are the naming words here? Can you identify? Yes. Mohit is a name. Zoo is a name. And animals is a name. Okay, so which is here? Which is the capital letter? And which letter word is in capital letter? Mohit. So, proper noun. What about? See, zoo. Zoo is a place. It is any particular zoo? No, it is not written any particular zoo. So, it is a common. And here, animals. Any particular animals are there? If I am saying that, so these two, animals and zoo, is a common noun. But there, if I say that Mohit likes to go to the Siddharth Zoo, or we can say the National Park, National Zoo. So National Zoo, and I am talking about the national particular zoo, so that is a proper noun. If I am saying Mohit likes to go to the National Zoo and sees the lion, tiger, you know, that is a proper noun. This is the difference between this proper and a common noun. Okay, we go to the next, that is a collective noun. Collective, collection. All together, collection of things, collection of places, you know, the rain. What we can say? Himalayas, Himalayas range. Many, this one, what we can say that Himalayas ranges. Okay, and we can say that team. Team, football team, cricket team, you know, that team. And staff, the teacher's staff, you know, staff, the collection of teachers, that is a staff. Bunch of keys. When the keys are together, that is called a bunch of keys. Flowers, when we are keeping the flowers together, we say that a bouquet of flowers. So, when and a herd of animals, herd, army, army, the collection of the soldiers, collection of soldiers are called the army. Understand? Collection of army. Collection of army. So, that is a collective noun. When crowd, crowd the collection of people, that is called audience, the collection of people, those who come to see, this is called a collective noun. Come to the material. Material. Which type of, see, this pen is made up of plastic. Plastic is a material. Understand? See, material, any type, gold, silver, cotton. This dress is made up of cotton. Jute. My bag is jute bag. So that is a material. Very easy to understand the material noun. Now, the, see, the fifth one is an abstract noun. As we see, the abstract noun, ideas, things, ideas and qualities. Ideas and qualities. See, that is abstract noun. Honesty. He is very honest boy. That he has that quality that is not in physical existence. We cannot touch that. We cannot feel that. Here only the honesty that we can see the quality. Understand? And the love. Understand? Our teachers are very lovable teacher, kind teachers. That's a quality they have. So that is an abstract noun. Happiness. That is an abstract noun. These are very important, you know, that quality. Okay, then if we see that abstract nouns, we cannot touch them or we cannot see them. Just now we see that okay, honesty is the best quality. Our emotion, that is also abstract noun. So, this is the main things that we see in the kinds of noun. Now, we'll see countable and uncountable noun. After that, we'll take one a small exercise. We have seen all the five and the abstract noun. In that, we have now we'll see the formation of abstract noun. Formation of abstract noun. See, by adding, how you will do that, the abstract noun, formation of abstract noun. See, by adding the suffixes. Suffixes such as nes, N-E-S-S, nes, T-I-O-N, shun, T-H, the, you know, T-H, the, A-G-E-H, M-E-N-T, meant, these are the suffixes, etc. To some verbs and adjectives. If we want to form abstract noun with verb or some adjectives, we have to add the suffixes. Suffixes is this, you know, N-E-S-S, T-I-O-N, T-H, M-E-N-T, A-G-E. If you are adding with verb and adjective, this, this will get the abstract noun. That is a called a formation of abstract noun. Can we see? Now what is mean by, you will say that what is suffixes, madam? Okay, we'll come to the point, the first the prefixes and the suffixes. What is mean by prefixes? Prefixes like this word, D-I-S-T-S, I-M-N, and like this, many are there. If you are adding before a word, before a word, if you are adding this, you know, this, in, an, that, you will get, that is called the prefixes. For example, now suppose your D-I-S, this, I-N-A, U, N, and all the these words, when you are writing, you know, letters, that is the meaning of that is no. That is the meaning of not. N-O-T, not. So what is that? See here, like. Now you have to add the prefixes for this, you know, for this, you know, balance possible. What will you add then? Like is a positive. As I said, prefixes before word when you are writing like this, many are there. I have written only few here. That the meaning is no. That meaning is not. So what you will write here? See, okay, this line. That is prefixes you are adding before a word. Means dislike means? I dislike that ball. Dislike. I did not like that ball. Okay, ball. Now, balance, imbalance. So, when you are adding that prefix, you know, that is imbalance. Now, possible, impossible. Impossible. That is, if something is possible, no, no, that is impossible. Is correct? No, not. So, prefixes is when we are adding, that is before a word, the exact opposite of that, that is a suffixes. Suffixes after a word. Which words were required just now? We have seen here th, prion, age, ment, you know, age, th, prion. These are the, these words, if you will add after the word, after the word, that is called adding suffixes. When you are adding suffixes, that you will get the abstract noun. See here, now if I have written here short, after the word, when you are attaching age, shortage. If you are short, age. Sad, sadness. N-E-S-S-ness, sadness. Adding suffixes. Then we get the abstract noun. See your friend, friendship. Friendship. We are getting that when we add that abstract nouns by adding the suitable suffixes. And dear children, keep in mind, when we are adding the suffixes, sometimes you have to change, you know, in some cases you may have to change the spelling. You may have to change the spelling of the words. Spelling of the word. Where we have changed the spelling of the word? See here, H. This here the spelling is S-H-O-R-T, short, but we have it, okay, here we have not written, friendship, okay, here also we have, but see here, here is kind, here we have not changed, okay, kind is there, and next we have already added, but short, S-H-O-R-T, A-G-E we have added, okay, but somewhere, and, you have to change the spelling. You have to change the spelling. That is add. We have written here extra and shall we have written. So somewhere you may have to change the spelling when we are forming the in abstract noun. She has seen child. We have added here hood. Enjoy, enjoyment. Only somewhere. Now D-E-E-P. D-E-E-P, deep, suppose we are writing here D-E-E-P, deep, what is the abstract noun of this, deep, depth, D-E-P-T-H, D-E-P-T-H, see, the spelling of deep is here, deep, but we have changed when we are changing into abstract noun, that is D-E-P-T-H, depth. I think so, the formation, hope you understood this, that the formation of a abstract noun. Now we'll see the countable and what is, you know, the some rules are there in the countable and uncountable noun. That we'll see, and we'll see our exercise. The last part of this lesson, that in the kinds of noun, countable nouns. And what is the difference, you know, the most of the times you children, and not only you, we the elderly people also do the mistake. So that is a common, what is there that you must know, that is a countable. Countable nouns, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, that we can count. That is a countable. You know, few countable children were there in the assembly. That is a count. We can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Uncountable, that we cannot count. You know, heap of sugar. That if it is a heap of sugar, heap of sand is there, that we cannot count. those things are called uncountable nouns. Okay, what is a countable noun? For example, book, pen, pencil, bag. Okay, go, how many pencils are there? So you can count pencil and you can tell. Like the same thing, the bag, pen, these are the countable nouns. Uncountable, water, that the measure we can say, you know. So, but here, water, juice, tea, air, sugar, etc., advice, love, and that, that is a uncountable, that we cannot count like this, you know, that is uncountable. Countable, as we can write, there is a book, there is an umbrella, this, there are many books, you know, the plural also we can use in the countable. But uncountable, we cannot use, oh, there is a sugar, no, there is not a sugar, there is a water, no. So, with the uncountable, we cannot use an, a, or any plural verb, okay. We can, there we can use the measures or a unit. If I am saying, give me 2 glasses of water. There is 2 glasses of water on the table. That we can say, can you give me 1 kg of sugar? Give me 1 kg of sugar for the air and all, you know. Air is a gases. There we can, it is uncountable. So there we can use measure or unit, but not a plural verb or a or an. We cannot use for a uncountable noun. What is there then? Countable nouns, we can use, we always say, how many books are there on the table? How many? There, for the countable, we always use how many, but for the uncountable, we cannot say how many water is there. No, we cannot say how much water is there. So, that is the difference. When we are saying about telling about the countable, we always say many, and for the uncountable, we always say much. There is much water in the tank. There is less water in the tank. In this way we can say, but not how many uncountable. For the countable, we always use how many. Now, see, if I want to say a few, you know, a few benches are there in that class. If I don't know the particular number, how many benches or tables are there in my class, so we can say tentatively, a few benches are there in my class. So, for the countable, we always use a few when the number is not, means tentatively we are saying, if the number is not fixed, so we can say a few. But in uncountable, we say that a little tea is there in the jug. A little coffee is there in the cup, not a few. This is, you know, very minor mistakes we do when write or when we talk. So, keeping here, these are the countable, uncountable. With the countable, we always use a and the plural. And here we cannot, here we can use the measure, that is the units we can use. Here, for the countable, how many we can say. And for the uncountable, we say always how much. And if the quantity is not fixed, we say a few books are there on the table. Don't know the particular number, so you can say a few in the countable. But in the uncountable, we can say a little water is there in the bucket. So in this way. Now the last point, that is, we see the exercise. Now you have learned. I hope you have understood everything, and very easy lesson, dear children. So exercise. What is the exercise number one? That is, identify the underline nouns. So now we have to underline the nouns. Which is nouns? Nouns, naming word. That may be the proper noun, common noun, pronoun also. You know the pronoun, instead of, we use the word instead of a proper noun. So here, see, they. National park is a noun, that is a name. Seema is a name. Okay, jewelry is, we can say. The gold,
silver,
noun, cattle.
Yes, dear children.
You're very correct. Delhi.
Very good.
Yes, India.
Okay, this is the problem. This we can say, you know, the proper pronoun is there. So we leave that. We'll see that in the proper and common noun we are seeing. So we'll not see this. Okay, kind, honest, right?
These are the nouns. Now we have to identify how many nouns are there. Proper noun, common noun, material noun, again what is there? Abstract noun and a collective noun. Just these five are there, and from these five we have to identify this. Okay, what is there? They went to the national park. Common or this is common noun or proper noun? Proper noun always starts with yes, capital letter. So this is proper
noun. Very good children, this is a proper noun.
Seema, yes, capital letter, so
proper noun, correct.
Jewelry, you know it, jewelry, it's a
common noun. If I say
jewelry is made of gold, so that is,
so here the common noun, gold, material noun. This is also material noun. Okay,
cattle. Cattle is?
Yes, collective noun.
Delhi?
Of course, proper noun.
India? Delhi is a capital of India. India also?
Proper noun.
She is a very kind. Kind. Is there any physical existence? No. Feelings? Yes. Idea? Yes. So there is feeling, you know, quality. She has a quality. She has a quality. Kind.
Of course, abstract noun. Honest, abstract noun.
Very good, children. I hope you have understood all this complete lesson. You have your dear children textbook, that is open your textbook, grammar textbook, that is from page number 11 to page number 14. Go through that, and in that book you write with the pencil. Thank you and have a nice day.